Last time, we explored the very best movies released in Australian cinemas in the last 7 months. Now, for the worst list. Here are the most vile, putrid, rancid, unbearable travesties I've already wasted my time and money on so far this year. First up, The Fifth Wave, which takes some of my favourite actors and dumps them in one of the most unoriginal movies of the year without a single original idea of its own. The love triangle is forced and pathetic, the action is easily forgettable, the pace is dire, and it's predictable as hell. Next up, The Huntsman, Winter's War. A thoroughly unnecessary sequel, The Huntsman, Winter's War is a cliché-ridden slog set in a generic world that's populated by bland characters. Allegiant. Allegiant is just as slow, boring, and unimaginative as the two previous Divergent movies, with a formulaic narrative and a cast that cannot be more disinterested. The Angry Birds movie. The Angry Birds movie is yet another failed video game movie with a paper-thin plot that's about 90% padding, weak humour, and annoying characters. Next up, Independence Day Resurgence. One of the most empty, passionless blockbusters in recent memory, Independence Day Resurgence is completely devoid of originality, doing nothing more than rehashing the original's plot. Everything here, from the story to the production design to the action, it's all been done before and done so much better. If you're a fan of the original, just go back and rewatch it. It's the exact same bloody movie, just the original is a million times better. Alice Through the Looking Glass. A mind-numbingly boring, cheap-looking, unimaginative slog, Alice Through the Looking Glass has a lead that's impossible to root for, as she almost destroys the whole of reality just to save a single unlikable character whose friendship you do not buy for a second, noticeably poorer effects than the original, pathetic humour, and once again Disney fails to understand Carol's source material on a fundamental level. The best example of this is how they give certain characters' backstories and motivations. But guess what? They don't need backstories or motivations because they live in Wonderland and everything is meant to be absolutely bonkers with no logical reason because it's Wonderland. If you can't understand the source material on a basic, fundamental level, just leave the franchise alone. Cabin Fever, a pointless shot-for-shot remake of a movie that's only 15 years old. The 2016 remake of Cabin Fever is a tedious slog with dire pacing, bland characters, and the only scares on offer are gratuitous gore and irritating jump scares. Jane Got a Gun. Despite great performances, Jane Got a Gun is a lifeless bore with dire pacing and flat direction. Grimsby. Grimsby is devoid of Coen's usually inspired satire, trading it for lazy, gross-out humour and poorly written characters. How to Be Single, an incompetent rom-com with a lazy script with thin characters, painfully unfunny humour, and Rebel Wilson is about as funny as being waterboarded. The Forest. Despite a promising location, that being the Suicide Forest in Japan, The Forest was a mind-numbingly boring and unscary slog that's completely reliant on jump scares and stale clichés. Zoolander 2. Zoolander 2 is a thoroughly disappointing sequel, with lame jokes, too many subplots, and too many pointless, distracting, and self-indulgent celebrity cameos. Point Break. A lazy, poorly made, incompetent, and most of all pointless remake, Point Break is devoid of likable characters with a ludicrous plot and lifeless action set pieces. The Choice. Yet another movie based on a book by Nicholas Sparks with all of his usual tropes and cliches, The Choice is an emotionally manipulative bore with cheesy dialogue, a terrible script, and flat direction. The Boy. With tedious jump scares, embarrassing dream sequences, and a stupid plot twist during the third act, The Boy wasn't just deeply unscary, it was mind-numbingly boring. Next up, Melissa McCarthy's Insufferable The Boss, with its awkward humour, irritating characters, dire pacing, and cliched story. Criminal. Not even this immensely talented cast could save Criminal from its ludicrous plot, awful dialogue, and generic and stale action set pieces. Next up, Batman v Superman, Dawn of Justice, which might just be the biggest letdown of the year so far, with a convoluted script overflowing with plot holes, character motivations that don't make a lick of sense, and the big fight we all pay to see has a pathetic resolution. Such a soul-crushing disappointment. Let's hope DC gets their act together soon. The Darkness. Such a disappointment from one of my all-time favourite directors, Greg McLean. The Darkness is devoid of scares, with a generic, cliché-ridden script and dull characters. The Purge Election Year. Easily the worst Purge movie to date, with cheesy dialogue, embarrassing performances, repetitive action, and my god, does it beat you over the head with its political commentary. Cell. Cell is one of the worst movies based on a Stephen King novel I have ever seen. It's cheap looking, poorly paced, the action is terribly shot, and the climax is simply infuriating. Dirty Grandpa, a viciously unfunny slog overflowing with childish cross-out humour, which honestly isn't even that shocking, an inconsequential and repetitive plot, two leads with zero chemistry, and the character's growth and lessons learned are insultingly basic and predictable. London Has Fallen. London Has Fallen's cliched characters, hilariously bad special effects, and cheesy dialogue would have been bad enough, but for it to go on and to comment on a delicate subject like drone warfare in such a one-sided and simplistic way is just insulting. Next up, Gods of Egypt. Wow, Jared Butler's really had a bad year, hasn't he? Gods of Egypt's whitewashing is just the tip of the iceberg. The story is generic, the dialogue is cringeworthy, and the performances are dreadful. Oh, and the director's attempts at a Fendi's movie by insulting critics isn't doing him any favours. Friend Request. Friend Request is an unintentionally hilarious, pathetic, unscary, social media themed horror movie about a bland teen who's haunted by the spirit of a dead girl who killed herself after she unfriended her and did not review this last year. A frustratingly unscary bore, Friend Request has nothing insightful to say about social media, with an abundance of cheap jump scares, cringeworthy dialogue, annoying characters, and a lazy script littered with plot holes. Me Before You. Me Before You was insufferable when it was being a boring, cliché chick flick, but it becomes a truly disgusting and morally bankrupt disgrace when it introduces its ableist messages, teaching viewers disabled people are better off dead rather than burdening their loved ones. Me Before You is one of the most disgusting movies of the year so far, and I despise it with every fibre of my being. Ice Age Collision Course. Why are they still making Ice Age movies? They've clearly run out of ideas, and that feeling of creative bankruptcy is abundant throughout the entirety of Ice Age 5, with a lazy, phoned-in plot and bored voice actors. Please, 20th Century Fox, please let this franchise go extinct. Next up, Mother's Day. Mother's Day is a lazy, boring, poorly made, and embarrassing train wreck with painful humour. Next up, Meet the Blacks. A painfully unfunny parody of The Purge, Meet the Blacks does nothing but miserably drown in racist jokes for 90 excruciatingly slow minutes. The Other Side of the Door. What could have been the moving story of a grief-stricken mum dealing with the loss of her child instead becomes yet another generic horror movie overflowing with cliches, jump scares, and stupid characters. 50 Shades of Black. How did Marlon Wayans toss up a parody of one of the worst movies ever made? Instead of deconstructing 50 Shades of Grey's flaws in funny ways, like a good satire should, all we got was racist and sexist jokes and offensively juvenile gross-out humour. Now on to number one. The worst movie of 2016 so far is Norm of the North. An agonizingly painful, irritating, rancid abomination. Norm of the North's characters are obnoxious, the animation is appalling, the voice actors sound bored, the jokes are insufferable, and its environmental message is delivered in the most condescending and pathetic way possible. Now, I know you could make the argument, oh, it's for kids, it doesn't have to be great, stop complaining. But here's the thing. Movies are such an important part of growing up. They shape us into the people we become as adults. If it wasn't for the movies I watched growing up, I would be a completely different person. They taught us life lessons, they comforted us, and they inspired us. But if kids are fed dumb shit, they're gonna become dumb shits. If they're not encouraged to think for themselves, they won't think for themselves. Just because you're making a movie intended for children doesn't mean you can slack off. If anything, that means you try harder.